What is this?
This is the tibia of left side.
Can you describe it?
It has a proximal end, shaft and distal end. Proximal end of the tibia contains two condyles. Between the condyles, there is an intercondylar eminence. This is the tuberosity of the tibia. This is the shaft of the tibia. It has three borders and three surfaces. This is the anterior border of the tibia. It is sinuously curved. This is the medial border of the tibia. And this is the lateral border of the tibia. Between anterior border and medial border of the tibia, this is the medial surface. Between the anterior border and the lateral border of the tibia, this is the lateral surface. This is the posterior surface. It has soleal line. This is the distal end of the tibia. It has articular surface for the talus. This is the medial malleolus of the talus, tibia. And there is a depression on its lateral surface for the articulation with fibula.
What is the largest joint in the body?
Knee joint.
What is the joint type?
Synovial hinge joint.
What are the articulations?
Between femoral and tibial condyles.
What
and
is
between
the
patella and patella surface of femur. Tibia.
Why is that?
Because shaft of tibia is subcutaneous and unprotected anteromedially throughout its course. Also, it is slender on its lower third.
Show me the nutrient foramen of tibia.
This is the nutrient foramen of the tibia.
Upper end of the tibial shaft is one of the commoner sites for acute osteomyelitis. Okay? But why usually doesn't involve knee joint?
Because capsule of the knee joint is closely attached around the articular surfaces, leaving the upper extremity of the tibial diaphysis extracapsular.
What are the structures that reinforce the capsule of knee joint?
On each side by medial and lateral collateral ligaments. Anteriorly, it is strengthened by the ligamentum patellae, and on each side of the patella, it is strengthened by expansion from the tendons of vastus lateralis and vastus medialis.
What are the bursae related to knee joint?
Suprapatellar bursa, popliteal bursa, semimembranous bursa, prepatellar bursa, superficial and deep infrapatellar bursae.
What are menisci? What are their functions?
They are crescent-shaped sheets of fibrocartilage. They are attached by their extremities to tibial intercondylar area and by their periphery to capsule of the knee joint. They deepen the articulation between femoral and tibial condyles. Also, they serve as cushions between them and act as shock absorbers.
What meniscus is more likely to damage?
Medial meniscus.
Why is that?
Because its mobility has reduced by the attachment of medial collateral ligament.
What are the structures that mainly determine the strength of the knee joint?
The tone of muscles acting on the joint and ligaments that binds femur to tibia.
What's the most important muscle group that determines the strength of the knee joint?
Quadriceps femoris.
What are the principal muscles that produce the movement of knee joint?
The extension of the knee joint is produced by quadriceps femoris. The flexion of knee joint is produced by hamstring muscles associated with gracilis, gastrocnemius and sartorius.
What muscle is responsible in unscrewing the knee?
Popliteus muscle.